Well, hi everybody, I'm Neil Smith, and welcome to my Revell 1/500 scale Star Trek Into Darkness USS Enterprise build. My version of this build will include the green strawberry photoetch parts, 5-color Aztec painting utilizing masks from Orbital Dry Dock, and a completely custom-made lighting and effects kit created by Stellar Effects. So let's get started. Step 1 of this build was the photoetch parts. The green strawberry kit contains parts for a shuttle bay, bridge, fan blades for the Bazaard collectors, deflector dish, impulse engine grill, and various other small parts to enhance the detail on the model. I began on the shuttle bay. The shuttle bay is very simply a flattened box that you fold into shape. After priming the parts, I quickly assembled the bay. Additional architectural elements and a second level were glued on, and then decals were applied. The decals that are included in the kit were very good decals, very strong, but not too thick, just about perfect. The green strawberry kit also comes with teeny tiny little resin shuttlecraft models with which to populate the bay. These needed even teenier, tinier photo etch wings to be placed under the engines. And when finished, I thought they needed a little something. They just looked a little plain when sitting on the hangar floor, and at that size, I knew I wasn't going to get a satisfactory look by painting them, so I decided to create some custom decals for them. I grabbed a schematic I found online of the shuttlecraft and used that as a guide in my graphics app to design the very small but very detailed decals. A bit of Microsol and everything settled into place, and the shuttlecraft looked great. The impulse engine housing part was carved out to allow for the photoetch grill to be installed. The impulse engines will be lit, so the photoetch grill will add so much of the look to it. The bridge also was put together and decaled, although I wasn't sure if I was going to actually use it or not, but I could decide that later. Other additional photoetch parts, airlock doors and such, were installed throughout the rest of the model. When starting on the deflector dish, I realized that I needed to address some color issues before I could begin. Specifically, I needed to figure out exactly what color of blue I was going to use to paint some of the clear parts. After a bit of testing and a lot of stepping through the movie Into Darkness frame by frame, I mixed up two blues. The majority of the clear parts would be painted in a sort of aqua color, while the deflector dish and a few other parts would be painted in a more of a traditional standard blue color. I don't know if this goes against what is officially recommended for this model or if it's different than what other builders are doing, but when it comes to the paint colors, I tend to mix my own colors based on what it looks like to my eye. And if that matches what I see in the reference material, in this case reference material being still frames from the movie, then I think I've got it right. So, clear parts all painted, it was time to get back to the deflector dish. The clear part for the dish was masked and painted in both blue colors, the aqua going where I wanted more light to show through, and the standard blue going where I wanted less light to show through. The brass photoetch parts were painted in a custom mixed copper paint and then carefully glued onto the dish. A quick test with an LED showed me it would look pretty good once installed on the model. At this point, I started prepping some of the parts of the model for lighting. While this kit is designed to be lit, there were several sections that I wanted to light that, in its original form, were not designed that way. Specifically, the raised section on the upper saucer going back from the bridge towards the impulse crystal has these little horizontal windows or lights or whatever. On the model, these are solid plastic, so they needed to be carefully cut out. I started with a drill to generally remove the plastic and then smoothed everything out with a sharp X-Acto blade. Another area I wanted to light was at the top rear section of the warp nacelles. There are these, what I call fins, that extend outward and are lit from underneath when the warp drive is activated. And while I wasn't planning on having those fins actually move, I did want to light them from underneath. So I needed to cut them apart from the nacelle parts, and this was done with a super sharp X-Acto saw blade, and then everything was sanded smooth. I numbered all the little cut pieces so I'd be sure not to mix them up when it came time to reinstall them later on in the build. So with most, but by no means all, of the customization of the main parts completed, they were all masked off and given several coats of black paint, followed by several coats of white paint on the insides for light blocking purposes. Following that, all of the windows and other clear parts were installed and glued in. Wiring, lighting, and all the other electronic goodness was going to happen next. And so that's all the time we have for this episode. Be sure to subscribe to follow along with the rest of the build. And if you're interested in any of my recommended modeling tools and supplies, check out my Amazon store in the description below, featuring some of my favorites. And until next time, I'm Neil Smith of WorkSmith 3D. Thanks for watching.